Quai des Polars.
Quai du Polar.
Quai du Polar.
Quai du Polar.
Quai du Polar.
They have been called to investigate the investigation into the death of a deacon in the Church of England. And this deacon has been brought in for questioning because he's been charged with pedophilia. And while he is in the police station, he commits suicide, or so it seems. The first investigation agrees with the conclusion of suicide, and the father of the deacon is wealthy enough that he is able to get a member of parliament, his member of parliament, to go to New Scotland Yard and mount a second investigation. So the investigation is not only about the death of the deacon in the church, but in the police station, but it's also about the investigation and whether there was a cover-up as well. The underlying story is about parents and children, and in particular the relationship between children and their mothers. And there are three mothers that we look at during the course of the novel. The mother of a girl named Misa, and Misa is very important in the story, and her relationship with her mother and how her mother tries to control her is also really important in the story. And then there's a relationship between a policewoman and her son, and then the relationship between the head investigator and her twin sons. So I'm sort of examining more than one item in the book. That's a really good question about the characters and how do you sustain characters over 20 novels. And I think the important thing for a writer is, I think a writer can go one of two ways. Either use the investigators just as tools of the story, so their purpose is just to go in and solve the crime, or the writer can become involved in the lives of these characters. And I chose that route, to be involved in the lives of the characters. And as a result, they never get old for me. I'm never tired of them. I really like them a lot. And when they come into a book each time, when their first moment on the screen appears and as I'm writing, it's always like I'm welcoming friends back. So I'm very fond of them. Well, I think that's basically the human condition, that most people have something either in their lives, their present or their past, or something that they believe or something that they feel that they're hiding from other people. I think that we never know anyone else completely. We can barely know ourselves completely. So we all are hiding, and yes, then that's the case in the book too. Everybody has something that they are hiding, even if it's the most minor character. There's something that the other characters don't know. And an example of that is the character Francie in the book. And she's the friend of one of the more significant characters. And she is very sexually profligate, and we don't really know why. I mean, it's just who she is. And then her good friend discovers what her relationship is with her parents and how much that has to do with who she is today. And it's that idea that you keep discovering things about people.